Hello all, welcome to my channel Tech Altivals. So today we are going to discuss about NRRATCH, Random Access Processor. So it is almost you can say same as LT only, but there are a few changes that we are going to be discussed in this. So let's start. Random Access Processor. So Random Access Processor basically is of two type: contention based Random Access Processor and contention-free random access processor. That in short we are telling as CBRA and CFRA. So in figure also I have illustrated about how contention-based RA processor works. So you can go through what exactly the contention-based RA preamble processor is. So in CBRA, the UV randomly selects a RA preamble, you can say, from the preamble pool, which is all that preamble pool is already set by the other UVs also in the cell. So if the multiple UVs select or transmit the same preamble, that is message 1, then all those UVs decode the same message 2, that is but obvious. So the UVs which are transmitting or you can say selecting the message 1 same preamble message 1, the same will be get decoded at a message 2 content, and transmit message 3 on the same UL time and uplink time frequency resource, UL time frequency resource. So in the next step, that is message 4, here only you can say network is able to resolve the contention. That's why it is like contention based RA. So message 4, so we will already we know that how the question arises, that when exactly the contention resolution happens. So this is on message 4, and this contention resolution happens on the basis of, you can say, the TA, the timing adjustment, which is sent by E-node B to UV based on that. So we will discuss this also, you can say, in LT part. So let's go to the next, that is contention free. Before that, you can see here, like message 1, random access preamble is sent by UV to Gnode B, and Gnode B responds with the random access response that we know name as message 2, and then after UV respond with the message 3, which is scheduled view SCS transmission, and message 4 where the contention resolution happens. So this is the simple diagram on and the simple explanation which I am giving. So now just go to the second point, that is contention free RA processor. So in contention free RA processor, UV uses a dedicated preamble which is provided by the network via this RRC signaling and the PDCCS order. So this is not like randomly it will select, it is already, you can say, provided by network. So we can see this random access processor basically you can say initiated by what are the things. So these are like a PDCCH order from the Gnode B, then this will be initiated, the UV MAC entity itself it will be initiated, and by RRC. So here also we can see like contention free RA processor in a simple diagram. So in Gnode B sends the RA random access preamble assignment, which is you can say now message 1 is sent by UV as a random access preamble, that is message 1, and after receiving that, Gnode B will send message 2, random access response. So this is the contention free RA processor in a simple diagram. So now the points come, the events which trigger the random access processor. So what are the events where basically random access processor starts? So this is, we can say, the point by point, like for the initial access, this random access processor is required. So initial access in this CBRA, you can say, contention based random access will be used. So already we can see in each point it is already defined by what actually it is categorized in CBRA or CFRA. So RRC connection re-establishment process, wherever the RRC connection re-establishment process will be there also random access procedure will be triggered. SR failure will be there, then it will be triggered. DLUL data arrival, whenever will the data arrival during the RRC connected. And uplink synchronization status is out of sync, then it can the processor can be started with the CBRA or CFRA both during handover and during the state transition from RRC inactive, where exactly it will be using the CBRA. A request for on-demand SI, system information, here also CBRA and CFRA. These are 5G terms you can say, like RRC inactive or request for on-demand system information, BIM failure recovery, CBRA and CFRA. This is for the 5G. So these are basically, you can say these three are like added. We can consider that this is for the 5G, that is, it's newly added. We will go through that. So now, random access resource selection, how exactly the resource selection will be there. So it is almost, you can say, it is similar to LT only. There is no much more difference. But below, you can say there are 3 points which I have already told you in previous slide, like BIM failure recovery, on-demand system information, it is SI request, and other CFRA cases are also there. We will go through that also. Now, so we will start with the random access resource selection for CBRA. So for CBRA, what exactly it happened? The UV first need to select an SSB before selecting the RA preamble. So the UV then select an RA preamble randomly with equal probability from the RA preamble associated with the selected SSB and the preamble which and from the preamble group. So it is like in both equally it will be selecting I BIM failure recovery config, otherwise it will go for CBRA. So the information elements for the BIM failure recovery. So the information elements of BIM failure recovery configuration. This is the information elements which we are using here is candidate BIM RS list, RSRP threshold SSB. Now, RA resource selection for the SI request, that is on-demand SI for UVs in RRC idle and the RRC inactive. Other SI request is triggered for the random access processor. If UV is configured by the network with the PRH resource for the SI request, CFRA is used, otherwise CBRA, it will go for the CBRA. So the network may configure the UV with the dedicated RACH for SI request purpose. With we have, you can say, there are IS, that is SI request config, that is transmitted in SI scheduling information. This is the information element which is in sieve 1. So in this case, what will happen? Message 1 is used to indicate the requested other SI. Here we can see. So when CBRA is used, SI request will go via message 3. The GNode will acknowledge the request in message 4. And for the configuration with the sync like handover, the RA configuration to be used is provided by the GNode B within RACH config dedicated. So this is, you can say, ICE in which GNode will provide the configuration. And we can see the for CFRA, the UV is configured with the SSB or CSI RS that is random access resource, CSI RS random access resource. Now, random access preamble transmission. This is almost same as LT, like RARNTI is used to address the UE on PDCCH, which in turn used for decoding of the PDSCH for the random access response, that is RAR. So in this what basically happens, like the MAC entity calculates the RARNTI except for the CFRA use, that is used for the BFR request. Now random access response reception. So once the random access preamble, RA preamble is transmitted, the UE waits for the acknowledgement from the GNode B in the form of RA response, random access response, that is RAR. And the UE monitors for the RAR by attempting to detect a DCI format 10 with CRC scrambled, that is by RARNTI or CRNTI within a window that is configured by RA response window. So these are information elements like RA response window. So in this random access response reception, the other thing is like for CFRA processor, the UE after receiving the RA response, RAR, considered that RA processor are successfully completed when it got the RA response. But for CBRA processor, the UE transmit message 3 over PUSCH using UL grant received in MAC RAR and proceed to the next step, that is for the contention resolution, message 4. So in this we can see like we have two cases will be there. Like if we'll consider case 1, where the RA preamble was transmitted for BFR, that is by using CFRA. So what will happen here? RA response window is picked from beam failure BFR, that is beam failure recovery config within RAR window, and UE monitor for the RAR on the search space indicated by the recovery search space ID. This recovery search space ID will be one of the information element of the SP cell. So within RAR window, if UE receive PDCCH addressed to the CRNTI, the UE considered the RA processor is a successfully completed. But if you take the other case, like apart from this case, in all other cases, RA response window is picked up by RAG config common. So what is the major difference? In case 1, I was mentioning that RA preamble, when it is transmitted for BFR, the RA response window is picked up by beam failure recovery config. But for the other case, RA response window is picked by RAG config common. This is one of the information element. So we can see, I have not mentioned here. So in RA response, that is from the network, this includes few of you can say. So in general, the RA response that we are getting from the network, this includes few of the parameters you can say, that is a rapid, that is random access preamble identifier, which is detected by the network, timing advance command, UL grant, and TCRNTI, that is temporary CRNTI. Now let's come to the message 3 transmission. So for CBRA processor, the UE transmit message 3 over PUSCH using UL grant that is received by the MAC RAR, and the UE includes an identified in message 3, which is used later for the process of contention resolution, that is message 4. So now what is contention resolution? That I have already mentioned, like we are telling that in message 4 it will be like the contention regression will be there. So once message 3 is transmitted, the UV start or restart the timer, that is RA contention resolution timer, and monitor for the PDCCH. So there also there will be two cases, like case 1, UV already had a CRNTI or you didn't have a CRNTI. So in both cases, like case 1 and case 2, if the contention resolution is not successful, the UV discards the TCRNTI and it will again go back to the random access resource selection procedure and retry for the random access procedure. So there are the two cases basically associated with this. So these are basically the main highlights and the points. There are a lot of things to go through this random access procedure. I also have, you can say, I try to go with the, all the topics, but this is a, you can say, a very big thing. If you go dig down, more information elements will be there, more cases will be there. So I have tried to just brief you can say highlighted points in this video, and in like 10-15 minutes video, not more top, you can say more topics cannot be covered. So if it will be like required, I will prepare more on this whenever I get more stuff or more clarity over this random access procedure. So for meanwhile, I have this much content on me. So please go through this and keep sharing. Please point out whatever the things need to be added, whatever the mistakes which I have done, so that I will be correcting those mistakes. And please read and please share. Thank you all.